That was the closing chorus, double chorus in fact, from Handel's oratorio Solomon. The Beecham Choral Society and the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra were conducted by Sir Thomas Beecham in his own edited and revised edition of the score. He avowed that he deliberately changed the traditionally accepted character of the work, which he viewed as non-ecclesiastical. And quite apart from that, the stylistic character and the weight and opulence of sound in his version, complete with the insertion of trombones, does belie a grand approach to Baroque music that's for some time been out of favour. Purists even then, back in 1956, were critical. But, as with Beecham's final edition of Handel's Messiah, which we'll be hearing later on in this documentary, Sir Thomas vociferously argued his case that Handel was very flexible in his performing exigencies, and in particular he loved to use as many performers as could be available on any given occasion. So it was that in this vein and spirit, Beecham created his three full-length ballet scores consisting of arrangements of many works of Handel he loved and intimately knew, and which were, in Beecham's day, rarely, if ever, performed in their original incarnations.
He knew all these scores, which nobody else looked at. And he was very important in the revival of Handel. I mean, his performances now would be considered anathema because of what he did, but he loved Handel, and he made people aware of Handel.